What's up? I'm Debby Ryan.
I'm Lucy Fry.
And I'm Adam, the director of the film.
Today, we're going to take you through a scene in Night Teeth, shot by shot. Hey.
So this is like the pivotal moment really in the film where Benny discovers that the girls are vampires. There was a sort of old school element to this sequence. The beds and even the doors that slide open, is someone cranking them. 15, 20 takes was just getting the doors to open at the right time. Debby had to take her hand off the bed and it had to flip over at that moment, but getting that timing perfectly right was difficult and long.
This isn't what it looks like.
Oh my God, he's shaking. I love it when they shake. It's so cute.
I love this. Like, yeah. Watching you so, like, delighted and how volatile Zoe can be, I think is so effective.
Thanks.
George hanging, like, his feet and you just
Yeah, the shot of the feet dangling is really good. To play, like, this is a meal was something that I've never really done before. I've been like, okay, I'm not interacting with you right now as a human being. I'm interacting with you as something that is food.
I bet Jay gives good blood. Don't you, Jay?
I'm not Jay.
What?
We did so much massaging of the dialogue, and I feel like this is one scene where so much of it plays not even in the words, just in the moments.
I love Adam's direction, how you'll say, like, yeah, go that far, and then see what it's like when you come back and, like, simmer down a little into it.
We went, you know, pretty wild at this moment to see how she reacts, thinking it's Jay, how she reacts when she's going to rip his throat open, but also how she reacts when she finds out it isn't. I mean, I remember on the day Lucy was screaming, crying, laughing.
We were, like, fighting, like, physically throwing ourselves sort of at
each
other.
You were like calming Zoe down and being like the grounding force.
I was like playing with your hair, which is, and it's like, no, we're okay.
I think the version we ended up with was where she's really just having the thoughts and kind of thinking about it, and all of it's like, you can see the thoughts happening between all of us because it's so nuanced what's going on.
I knew it.
What did I tell you? I knew this little shit couldn't be Jay Perez.
All right. Let's drink the driver.
So this was all shot in a stage.
Ultimately, what it is a box. So blocking it is incredibly difficult. You know, often you can rely on things for the cast. They're able to sit down, they're able to play with props. But this was just three actors and two unconscious actors in a room. So in that way, it was really challenging to find an interesting way to block this and to perform it.
What? No.
You could come in handy.
Handy for what?
I think it was also such a good touch of Adam to Photoshop his abs on that actor.
Thank you. Those abs were actually incredibly difficult because you could see that he breathes, so we had to actually VFX those abs.
Wait. I bet he could take us to Jay.
Benny, do you think you could do that? Do you think you could show us where your brother is?
That was great.
The idea with this is that this is a place of sort of perverted pleasure, you know, and that people pay to have their blood sucked. And so we wanted to really make it feel opulent in a way and make it feel like old money. So there was a lot of kind of brass and gold and leather.
Hey, Max, you okay?
Yeah, man, I'm fine. I'm living my best life.
Are you crazy?
The other challenge with this scene in the script, they were hanging upside down. That's how Benny finds them, these two guys hanging from chains from the ceiling. And it didn't feel quite right in terms of the sort of luxury. And then practically, we found out that if you hang someone upside down, they've got about 30 seconds, and then you have to put them up the right way. So we realized to shoot this would have taken about 2 weeks. So we thought, how else can we do it? And we came up with this sort of, the idea of these kind of gravity beds.
Is he?
He's dead. Yes, dead. Yes, he's dead. I killed him.
No, you can't do this.
We talked about this, like, the concept of, like, a shark and a cat. And so I studied a lot of, like, cat movement and was watching, like, when there's, like, one prey and, like, the person who protects the prey, like, being like, no, this is ours. Like, this is mine. But then when you go over and interact with Daniel and Max, pacing around him, like, circling him and sort of just, like, standing over him. This was the first time it felt really, like, creepy sort of in our bodies.
We're protected. This place is protected.
Protected? How protected do you feel right now? Come on, Blair, finish your drink. We're running behind schedule.
I just love this moment with us because I feel like it shows our friendship. Yeah, we're gonna feed together, like have a nice glass of wine, like out of the neck, like cheers.
I remember when I proposed the concept, finish your drink.
Yeah, like a drink.
Because it keeps it a little bit human.
No, wait, hey, wait, no, don't. Please, wait, listen, you can't kill me. You can't, what about the truce? The truce.
The truce is dead, Hanson.
This last moment was completely unexpected, where Lucy rests her head and watches Debby feeding. There's genuine love there. You know, it's like a weirdly sweet moment where she's looking at her with such adoration that I remember seeing her, you know, on the monitor, and just every take from that moment on, she had to do that. I just thought it was brilliant.
Yeah, I remember finding that moment and just being like, this feels so sweet. Like, this is our friendship. This is what we do.
They need each other. They're each other's like soulmates and partners, and they've done so much life together.
They have a great friendship, and you're like, they're so good.
I'm like, it's a problem. This has been a discussion with my co-stars in the movie Night Teeth and our director on breaking down one scene shot by shot. Check out Night Teeth now on Netflix.